Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. In today's video I would like to talk about brand identity for social media. So I would like to talk about how you can get recognized, how you can do branding for social media, for your small business, for your brand, for your personal brand, for you as an entrepreneur or a content creator. I would like to talk about brand identity. I would like to start with telling you a bit why it is important to have a brand identity, and then we are going to go into the how, more of a hands-on advice. So let's start off with why it is important to have a brand identity, and you probably already know that is important because you were already looking on Google for this subject and you came across this video, and you probably know that is important, but I would like to tell a bit more why I think it's important. I think it's important because with a good branding you can get recognized when people are scrolling on their Facebook and they will see a picture of you. They will recognize your brand if you have a consistent branding. It also represents your brand. Sometimes if your branding doesn't match the values of your brand or it doesn't match the personality of you, then you might have some kind of mismatch and people don't really know that they should be picking for you. But that's something that we are going to go into a bit further in the how of this video. So it's so important to think about brand identity so that you and your brand can grow on social media but also as a business. So that's a bit the why of this video. Let's go into the how. And first I would like to talk about visual identity. And visual identity, I think it has to do with colors, it has to do with fonts, it has to do with what kind of images you want to use, it has to do with filters that you would like to use. But let's start with the colors. And you probably already have thought about a logo, you've thought about a font that you want to use, but are you using it consistently? Are you thinking about when you are putting pictures online? Are you thinking about the fonts that you want to use? Are you thinking about the colors of your logo? Are you thinking about the colors of your website? That's something that you really should think about. And if you don't have a brand guide yet, if you don't have a logo yet, this is the perfect moment to start thinking about it. And even if you have a logo and you have a website, then you can think about how can I make my social media posts also look like the branding that I already have. You have different colors that you can use, and actually all of the colors in the color wheel, they have some kind of emotion that they evoke, and there's some kind of emotional background to colors as well. It's also a bit cultural. But mostly blue stands for business, for financial services. Red stands for passion, like a red Ferrari, for instance. If you go to green, it's more like a biological feel. You know, all the bio products, they have a green logo. So that's something to think about, is how, what color am I going to use? You probably already have a personal favorite color that some might also match your personality. For me, my favorite color is blue. I'm wearing a blue shirt. I have a blue black background. My logo is blue. This is blue. Maybe that is just meant to be, but think about what kind of color do you want to use, what kind of color matches my brand and my personality. Then after you think about your colors, you could also think about the fonts that you're using. There are so many different kind of fonts. You have typewriter fonts, you have serif fonts, sans serif fonts, you have handwritten fonts, and all fonts, they have some kind of feeling attached to them. If you see a handwritten font, it's more loose, it's more freely, it's more for spiritually free people, it's more for if you have an entertainment business. But if you have a financial business, most of the times they are going to go more into sans serif fonts or maybe serif fonts. So that's something to think about, the style of the font that you are going to use a lot also represents you as a brand as well. And the same goes for filters. What kind of filters am I going to use on my picture? Do they match my brand? And also, what kind of images am I going to use? And the images, what you are going to use as a brand and how you are going to take them and what is in the images, the smallest details can make a world of difference. So for a test, let's have a look at these two pictures. These are two pictures that I took from a copyright-free stock site, and both of the images, they both have a laptop, but one of the images is more business-minded, with a guy sitting there with a suit, with his expensive watch. And the other, there is an analog camera there, there is coffee, there is even some crumbles next to the hand. The watch is more relaxed, there's pictures next to it. So the picture on the left looks a bit more creative, while the one on the right looks more like a business kind of image. And that's only the small details where you can see the difference in between these two images. And that's also something to think about when you are doing your branding. How am I going to take pictures? What do I want to showcase in the pictures that I'm going to take, together with the colors, together with the filters, together with the fonts? This will be your visual identity. And I know this might sound so hard, but it's also a learning process. Start thinking about branding. And if you want to have a good idea of a brand guide, I will link a PDF in the description of this video. This PDF is for the big company called EasyJet, and I found this brand guide online, and there is a lot to learn from it. So please go through it. You will learn a lot from it, and how they think about how they want to communicate their brand. And if you want to create some kind of guide for your own, and if you want to think about branding, then something that you can do is just make a pin board on Pinterest and start looking for images that you like, for colors that you like, and start making a pin board, a mood board out of it, and that will make you create a mood board for your company, and so you will have the feeling that you want to portray as a company, and you will have some inspiration where you can look into when you are looking to create new images for your social media. So we talked about visual identity, and the next thing I wanted to talk about is recognition. And that's the thing, is when you have your branding, if you have thought about your images, is to stay consistent. Because once you have a consistent style and you have consistent style of images that you're using, when people are scrolling through their Facebook, they're going to recognize your pictures. They're going to recognize your branding. And maybe they don't even stop and comment, but they have seen it. And that will create brand awareness. And that will also make your brand, your small business, you as an entrepreneur, more top of mind whenever they are in need of your business. So making sure that you are consistent with your styling will make people to recognize your brand and will actually create more brand awareness. Next step is to think about visual storytelling. Because like I told you with the two pictures before, the two pictures were almost the same, but told a different story. And that's also something that you want to think about whenever you are creating pictures for your social media. What kind of story am I telling? Are all the elements that are in the picture telling the right story? You might be a dog groomer, and you might take pictures whenever the dog is finished, maybe one before and pose a before and after, and that's all good. But if your background is a bit messy, or if your lighting is a bit bad, then the story that you're telling might not be as good as you think it is. So also criticize yourself and think about, is it the story that I want to tell? Is it really told in this picture that I put online? I've seen so many people thinking that they thought of a good idea for their pictures, but then end up being very bad. And I'm not a saint. I make the same mistakes as well. Sometimes I'm so glad with a picture and I post it, and then if I look back to it a couple of months later, I think this doesn't really fit the brand that I want to tell and that I want to showcase. So really criticize yourself on the pictures that you put online and make sure that all the elements tell the right story, because a picture can tell more than 1,000 words, and make sure that you're telling the right story. If you are thinking about all the elements in the picture in a good way, you can create beautiful stories online, and that's something that we want to do with visual storytelling. Thinking about what are you telling in the picture, and can I create a story with just one still image? If you think about that, you will go a long way with that as well. And then the last thing that I want to talk about is stopping power. It's so important that when people are on Facebook, on Instagram, they are just scrolling, and your picture and your copy has to make them stop scrolling and have a second look at it and read about what you've written down. Have a look at your picture. So I don't know if you know, but sometimes you are scrolling, and sometimes I make the mistake and then it scrolls back up again, and then I'm a bit angry, but I'm thinking, I haven't been scrolling that long, so I can scroll back. And then I kind of see pictures that I haven't seen before, and then I think, oh, this is where I stopped, and then two pictures after that, I actually see a picture that I saw. And that is what is going on. A lot of people don't see your picture because they were just scrolling and they didn't care to stop. So also make sure that your picture has a lot of stopping power. And the best way to do that is to have a goal for your image. What is the goal? What is the thing that you want to tell them? What is the one thing that you want to portray in this picture? Think about that one goal in your picture. Will make sure that you're not trying to put a lot of messages in one image. It's always good to have, for a social media post, one social media post is one message. Don't try to get 3 or 4 messages into one picture, because people will get confused and people will not understand with the first glimpse that they get at your picture, and they will not stop. So if you liked this video, please give me a thumbs up and keep on watching to the rest of my channel. Subscribe if you want to keep updated on my latest videos. Here you can watch the next video on my channel. I see you next week. Bye.